More than happy to answer your question. Marco, thank you for coming to Burlington. Marco, on your decision making, will you follow God's word? And I hear so many people say the word God, but they don't want to define it with the word Jesus. Okay? As a Christian, as a believer, will your decision making be with Scripture and with the word God?
Yes. Let me begin with the second part of your question. As a Christian, I believe that Jesus is God. God became a man. Think about what an incredible thing that was. Again, as a Christian, I respect the people that have different views, but you asked me about my faith, I'm going to share it. It's interesting, I just read a passage a little while ago that says if you're asked about your faith, because it was talking about how when John the Baptist was arrested, Jesus retreated, since he retreated to Galilee, and ended up living in Capernaum and in that region. And he did three things. He went out healing and preaching and the commands and also inspiring people. And so the command, the devotional for today was saying, today you may have a chance to share your faith, and it may very well touch someone or inspire someone. So thank you for asking me that. It was literally almost spooky, right? So God created us, and then man broke away because man decided that it really was because of pride. The idea of something we do every day in our lives is we say, this issue is so big, God can't handle it. Let me take care of it. So man was tempted by pride and broke away from God, and it messed up the entire plan. And so for centuries, man was grasping to be with God, but there was a huge gap between us. And the only way it could be closed is for God to become a man and take our sins upon him and become the ultimate sacrifice, in essence, the ultimate Paschal lamb, right? Because in the Passover, when they came over from Egypt and they were freed, they commemorated it with slaughtering an unblemished lamb, and the blood of that lamb would cover our sins, but it could not erase them. So the ultimate Paschal lamb, this perfect, unblemished lamb, had to be God himself, became a man. And it became a man to think about how vulnerable he made himself. He made himself a baby, dependent on his family to feed him and raise him, and became a man that suffered everything we feel. So I don't think it's sacrilege to say God made man, had colds, maybe even got the flu. You know, we know he suffered great emotional distress. He wept when his friend died, even though he knew he was going to bring him back to life. It hurt him when other people, he suffered everything we've ever suffered. We know he confronted fear, so scared that he sweat blood, which is a real medical condition, by the way, brought on by high anxiety. So do I believe that Jesus is God? Absolutely. He's not just God. He's God made man. Perfect and can understand anything we're ever going to feel. That's an extraordinary thing. And not only that, it is the only way, I believe, deeply, that I will ever get to share eternity with my Creator, because I am permanently separated from him in the absence of him. As far as guiding my decisions, yes, I try every day in everything I do. And I'll confess to you now, and this is kind of a pretty big confession, as a Roman Catholic is usually one person, but fine to do it with everybody. Like everybody, we fail. Sometimes we try to handle it on our own. That's why people ask me, do you ever doubt your faith? And it's not what people think. I can't say I've ever, like anybody else, every now and then you wonder, what are the reasons of God? But very rarely, I really. Here's a real challenge to your faith. Every single day we are confronted with something, right? And we think to ourselves, in your behavior, when you feel anxiety and fear, what you're basically saying is, this issue's too big. God can't even handle this one. I'm going to have to handle. God, go ahead and handle my family. Go ahead and handle my health. Go ahead and handle all these other things. But this problem I have here is just too big. I'm going to have to handle this one, God. That's a lack of faith. What you're basically saying is, you don't think God is great enough to do that. I think we all fail in not going to God constantly to guide us in our decisions. And the last point I would make, as far as what you asked about making decisions, yes, I've never had a burning bush experience in my life, like literally or figuratively. I think God works in each of us in different ways. Here's what God has said, though. He will provide you the wisdom. And sometimes what happens is not what you wanted. Sometimes you really want something desperately, right? You want it to turn out this way. If I've ever had a burning bush, it's been one of these. I look back at my life at things that I really wanted, and I am grateful it didn't happen. Because you know if you had gotten what you wanted, it wouldn't have turned out well. But you wouldn't have known that back then. Because God is wiser than we. His ways are not our ways. And so I think having that level of trust is something I work hard at every single day. And I imagine until I draw my last breath, I will struggle with it like everyone does. but I continue to try to grow in that reliance in the hope that God can equip us with supernatural wisdom and understanding, and most of all, peace. And our faith constantly talks about peace. Peace in the Christian faith doesn't mean just peace, like, you know, peace or no war peace. Peace means being comfortable in any, being confident and calm in any circumstance you face. Peace means the boat is rocking, a storm is about to rip the apostles' boat apart, and Jesus is asleep. And they're all freaking out. We're going to die. And he's like asleep. He was at peace. And I think that's what it asks us to do, to be calm and to not fear. Fear is the tool. The devil uses fear to create in us all sorts of emotions that divide us from the right thing to do. So I know it's a long answer, but it's an important question I wanted to share with you. Yes, I try every single day to rely on my Creator and on my Savior to give me wisdom and understanding and discernment. And I will continue to do that in every aspect of my life.